It's been a very big week for politics, very big week. Abortion was removed from the Crimes Act last night, and the government made its $12.1 billion announcement on an economic response to COVID-19, the first in a series, Grant Robertson pointed out to us. So much to discuss with our Thursday morning political panel. And our regulars are with us today, Paula Bennett, our Nationals Deputy Leader and Election Campaign Manager, and Shane Jones, New Zealand First Minister. You're not even sitting side by side. Is this some kind of form of social isolation going on? Social distancing is there?
Yeah.
I presume so.
Yeah. I'm without my Jonesy this morning. It's like so close but so far away.
It's very Shakespearean of you. Let's talk about the $12.1 billion announcement. We had Simon Bridges on yesterday morning, Paula Bennett, so your boss or your leader. And I thought he struck an altogether different tone from his tone in the House about 18 hours earlier. Did he get it wrong in the House, do you think? Was that a too political, too oppositional, that response?
Oh, I don't think so. I mean, you're in the House, it is a different environment. There were questions he had that hadn't been answered. Kind of this, you know, reaching out and we're all in it together and let's not do the politics. Yet the reality was certainly very few briefings, no sort of reach out from ministers. And very different, like after the earthquakes in Christchurch, you know, we just had ministerial briefings with all MPs involved regularly, multiple times a week. And so we sort of hear this, that we should be working together, and yet the reality is that we just didn't see it. So, look, Simon gave a speech. It was pretty full on. It's what he does. But he is as concerned as every other New Zealander at the moment. And we have a job to do in opposition. And it's not always comfortable, but we have to ask the questions at really extreme times like this.
Shane Jones, that seems fair enough, does it?
Yeah, I think the circumstances are evolving. This is a silent and deadly enemy. And everything that we've conceived to be our ordinary habits of life are now going to change. I've moved on from Simon's off-colour speech. The reality is it's hard to get a balance and fairness to the opposition between probing and being patriotic. And I think his own team would have said to him, mate, you're a little bit over the top. Kiwis are genuinely suffering. We've got to stop this pettiness.
I asked you in the ad break while we were waiting to go on here how you were feeling this morning, and you said sombre. And it's a confusing and bewildering time, isn't it?
Yeah, I mean, you want to hope that there's something distinctive in a providential sense about New Zealand, but if you look at the stats and the trajectory of this affliction overseas, we obviously need to all work together to disrupt the transmission of this illness from me to my neighbour. And that's going to require Kiwis to contemplate a lot of things we've taken for granted and assumed as our birthright has to change. Because whilst I believe that we're keeping ahead of the curve, the reality is far more radical action, I suspect, will have to take place.
He's right, isn't he, Paula Bennett? And how do we... You're right, Paula Bennett. I'm going to come back to you. An opposition's job is to hold the government to account. And an opposition's job is to say, here's where we think you can do better. But how do we get the partisan politics out of that in the run-up to an election, which may or may not occur? It's still very much on. And how do we do what's best in the collective interest?
Which we are and will do. I mean, there's no two ways about it. We, you know, certainly had been calling for the job support package. We'd been calling for tighter border controls for weeks. I mean, just a few days before the government's announcement on Saturday, you know, we were hearing that it's all business as usual and everything's fine. And so, yeah, we started really pushing hard. And I'd like to think that actually we've been part of the reason that we've seen the government moving a bit quicker as well when they really needed to, because what we were hearing from them wasn't that they weren't going to. So, look, we will keep asking questions. I've still got major concerns at the moment around testing and the inconsistencies that we're hearing out there from people. We do worry about those medium-sized and larger businesses. Literally thousands of people are going to lose their jobs.
Simon Bridges raised that yesterday. So there is a cap on the wage subsidies, the wage support of $150,000 per business. What would you do for the businesses whose staff numbers are so great that $150,000 isn't going to make any difference at all?
Yeah, well, there does have to be something different for
them.
And what
would it be?
the jobs are the same. Well, we don't have the same information from Treasury as to what that modelling would look like, but we would definitely, I would think, raise that threshold for certain businesses so that they're able to keep them. And the hotels are a classic where they're talking about being at least 75% down, and of course that's not going to get any better. If anything, it's going to get worse. Thousands of people work in that industry, and so we have a job to do to try and keep them connected to their work as well. And so there has to be something different for those businesses. There's no two ways about it.
So you are saying lift the cap?
Yeah, I think lift the cap for certain businesses. It makes sense. It has to happen.
Shane Jones, can I come back to you? You travel the country, as your travel budget has demonstrated gloriously over the past 12 months. What are you seeing and what are you hearing in the communities that you visit? Are people losing their jobs? And if they're losing their jobs, then what is the impact of that on households?
Yeah, well, obviously, I'm on my way tomorrow to the Tairawhiti, and we're going to announce a package up there which will inject cash in a very short and sharp way. But look, the deeper reality is that New Zealand is moving to a place that certainly has never been in my lifetime. I don't remember a time when we literally will become, for a lot of the industry, an island to ourselves. If your business depends on the free transmission of people from other parts of the world, your business has just been inverted. We need to back, obviously, our employees, and there's a host of businesses we absolutely must keep in operation, not the least of which is food production. And we're going to see the backbone industries of New Zealand, and Kiwis are going to learn how important those backbone industries are, and obviously, not exclusively, but largely in provincial New Zealand.
Shane Jones and Paula Bennett, thank you so much for joining us this morning. We really appreciate it. And may you and all you love stay well. We're very grateful for your time. We wish you both well. Thank you.